influence of the Ohio, Allegheny, and Monongahela Rivers in Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, PA. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Houston Texans and the Pittsburgh Steelers.
The final weekend of the summer. Hope you're enjoying it wherever you are as we are off and running on EA Sports.
Takes it across
Mayfield
the 40-yard line.
Complete to
16 yards on the game's first play and a quick first
a
down.
16
one play
yards.
Has him up past the 40 already and another first and 10. Now Mayfield dancing to his left. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away.
Mayfield,
nice move there.
The keeper.
Like nobody open. Now second down.
Incomplete on the throw.
Second and 10 again for the 41.
It's second down and 10.
Here's Mayfield. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Torn back across his body. Picked up by Jordan Porter. To the 50 to the midfield stripe.
Mayfield pass.
That right there is the inauspicious start that they were hoping to avoid. No turnover.
The Steelers
on the first possession.
First and
I love how you use those college-bound words
line.
Like that. Inauspicious. Well done. I really appreciate that. But here's the thing for me. I'm just wondering if their game plan is incorrect.
Number 30,
you know, I think
James
they felt like they could come in and throw it around pretty well.
He was
that interception
the
early, they may
line.
Rethink how they go about attacking.
The pickup. Second and six.
Tonga Bailoa to throw on second down here. They'll find Juju Smith-Schuster. And he'll have him in the red zone before he crosses over the line. 28 yards the game there on the catch and run.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the
first
ball. I don't know what happened
the
last week to really hurt their performance and then hold down their production. But I would dare say that this week in practice,
and he's going to take it down for a Steeler touchdown. Devin Asiasi, his second touchdown of the season, and the Steelers have taken a first quarter lead. And he'll put it through to make it 7-0 Steelers.
Makes the score Steelers 7, Texans nothing.
Sanchez now will kick it away, driving the touchdown. And no return on this one as a fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Texans take over first and 10 at their own.
Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. And this will be a game of
Buckley
as he gets it to the 30.
Brought down
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup.
It's
on
a
first down.
Brings up second and 5.
Now Saquon Barkley. And he'll be brought down right around the 37.
Saquon Barkley, the ball carrier.
This running game so
Julian
important
Blackman
for them, and they
the
know
tackle.
That. It helped lead him to a victory
and
last week when he was
pickup.
Over 100 yards.
First
Let's
down,
face it,
Texans.
It's their identity. And that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week. And right now, we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
Defensive end
getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle. That's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback.
Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Avante Maddox. And a big turnover there. as his guys will get the football back.
Intercepted.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And certainly they're hoping to hit pay dirt like they did on the last drive. Got the football back, so a chance to get two scores.
And they haven't been tentative at all in this ball game, because sometimes you start a game with your script to try and get information out of the opposing defense, how they play you in certain situations. Sometimes you script to attack.
Second
and that's what I'm seeing so far.
At the 15-yard line.
On second down, Tua. He's tied in here, Asiasi. And they'll bring him down here up about the 22-yard line. Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down.
First and 10 at the 22-yard line.
On the counter is Jadeveon Clowney there on the stop.
On the carry.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. He picked up 4 yards on that carry. So now, if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want, but on the defensive side of the ball, you're screwed for a little bit. Now you're behind, trying to figure out, do I need to blitz it? Do I need to pressure it? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
That's a gain of 3.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
On play action, here's Tua. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off here by Jimmy Smith. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So, when they're in zone.
And he'll take this one in for the Texans touchdown.
Touchdown.
Saquon Barkley, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Texans are an extra point away from tying this football game. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Trevor Davis now to return. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive, followed by an interception last time out.
It sounds like things are balanced out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a defense zone, or then he bounces it out.
Second and
we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now.
And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. A gain of 13. It's a first down
at the 40-yard line.
From the gun, it's Tua. And left side here, Wilson. And he'll be taken down. And that will take us to the end of the first quarter. Second quarter action from Pittsburgh. It is the Steelers in control of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. Buying time to his left. And now he's going to use his legs. And he'll get it down the play to the 37. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there in second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
On second down, it's Connor. And tough sledding.
James Connor, the ball carrier.
Stop short of the 35.
He was brought down by Avery Williamson.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to throw from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact hit the ball through and it's fourth down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one. Closed quickly. And that forced the incompletion. Focusing on me is in Tel Aviv. Barbados with the hustle pockets that I need. Is
six figures every year. Yeah, earn that. At the front of this line is where my turn at.
Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in.
So taking a risk here early in the new year, they're going to go for it. Tua on fourth down. Open man is Asiasi, the tight end. They're able to keep the drive alive 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one. They fake the handoff. Now Tua over the middle. Incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Devin Asiasi there. Asiasi. Second down.
Incomplete. It leads to second and 10.
From the gun, a give to Connor. Yeah, he's got about 5 yards as he's taken down.
James Connor on the carry.
The second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
And Wilson has it.
Albert Wilson.
We have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy could be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for them, too.
So they hit pay dirt, but don't count it yet. There's laundry on the field. We'll see what the penalty flag is about. So erase the red zone score. They'll have to dial that one up again.
And you know how difficult it is to strike in the red zone because things are a little bit more condensed. Got to go back to the play chart and see if they can dial up another one.
5 yards will get them back to the original line of scrimmage, but now they're looking at 3rd and 10.
Smith, the one who brought him down.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not everyone's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
Wilson stands in left side, and he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the red. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I pick him up.
And he's in. Touchdown. James Conner. His 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Steelers have taken the lead.
Amy Fairbairn lining up.
A strong, determined run there, Charles, to get in for 6 points.
It is good.
This is why it's such a team game. It's more classic than the generic defense. The blocks were made up for the Ravens to go and collect the victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield. And how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
The Texans take over 1st and 10.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They trail a 1-score deficit 14-7 as they come up 1st and 10. They'll start out on the ground and Saquon Barkley. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31.
Barkley, the ball carrier.
Just a yard on the pickup there to bring up a 2nd and 9.
One yard to
just strike back with a touchdown. Right?
And
if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Hit as he throws there incomplete. Gronkowski, the intended receiver,
taking the ball down.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
On 3rd down, Mayfield. He is going to find Hill here. First catch Tyreek Hill, and he's got a 1st down.
A gain of 11
on the
play.
And a key number on that play,
1st down, Houston.
3rd play of the drive, 3rd down, spectacular catch, turns into a 1st down.
1st down saves him from a 3 and out. I will remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And now the throw hauled in by Green. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Another nice gain, 16 yards there at a 1st down again.
And the Texans, 1st down.
Check, 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 check.
has his guys who will get the football back.
Intercepted.
And that's not the second time he's picked off a pass here in the first half alone. Again, another great read defensively. And you just see him get in the right position to make the play and get his guys the football back.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And that last drive was so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, Honor's going to get down to those starters. Blocks up your spread. Get rid of those guys on offense and find a way to run through them.
Or run them
to get into the face of the pass.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they got to try something, because right now, they just cut them to shreds.
Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts.
They'll
get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down.
At the 49-yard line.
Now Tua. The left side here, taken in by Asiasi, the tight end. Another good gain. That's their 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
Well, so far, little to no resistance by the defense on this drive alone. Three passes, three completions, three first downs. They're taking it to him, and it's paying off.
Brings up the second
try again from the 36 on second and 10. Tua setting up shop to throw again. And Smith-Schuster, that's complete. The Steelers use the second of their three timeouts.
Juju Smith-Schuster.
As the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half.
Third and six.
Again, they will throw it with Tagovailoa. Open man, Smith-Schuster, it's complete. And he will have the Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And again, it's Tagovailoa. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. Now the Steelers going to use their third and final timeout as they start with 19 seconds to go in half number one.
First and goal at the 4-yard line.
The Steelers were last in the NFL in red zone touchdown percentage a season ago, down around 35%. It's first and goal. Looking for his tight end, Devin Asiasi there. But it'll be second and goal.
Leads to second and goal.
Ready to go here for their next drive. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
Seven.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three.
Mitch Wisnowski set to kick off.
So time for the second half as the Steelers have the lead, and they will also be receiving the football here to start the third quarter. And he returns this to the 22.
The Steelers take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Off of play action. Tagovailoa. Throw left side complete. That's Wilson. And he's going to get this one across the 3-yard line.
That's good.
He continues to deliver a first down here. He had four catches in the first half, and this one number five.
33-yard line.
Out of the shotgun, they'll run with Connor. And he'll be taken down right around the 34.
Number 30, James Hunter, the ball carrier. He's tackled at the 34-yard line.
Things are pretty stacked up there in the middle of the yard. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
And he'll get this one off.
James Hunter on the handoff.
He's brought down at the 39-yard line. Credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
That's complete to his running back, Connor. And he will have the Steelers' first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of six. Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. On the move to his left. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be Connor. He is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
First and 10.
25 yards that time. Tua. That's caught over the middle by Asiasi. As they call his number again, he's got 15 yards here.
First and 10 at the 14.
That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And now they're inside the 10 as he's punted down at the 9.
A gain of 5 brings up second down at the 9-yard
line. His pass caught at the 4. And he's out. Touchdown, Steelers. Devin Asiasi. His second touchdown of the game. His third of the year. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead. And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17.
Next to score, Steelers 24, Texans 7.
Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. And a fair catch signal fair for catch. And taken successfully.
The Texans take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
I can't wait to see what they have planned.
Number 26, Saquon Barkley, the ball carrier.
Other teams just go, okay, the these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things work well for us.
Brings up second and
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. So now it's third and long, because remember, they also lose a down on the grounding call. From the gun, Mayfield. He's going to air it out deep for Green. And that is incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up the way we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
Davis now to return it. A very nice punt that time. They get 11 back on the return.
And they're all
Steelers with the offense here, first and 10. So good field position for the Steelers as they come up first and 10 at their 38. And they'll run the option to start the drive. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That was a pretty good job defensively until a two-yard run, but I've got to think this offensive line, they're asking their quarterback for a different type of run, one that they rely on, one they have confidence in, one they feel like they can block.
Tua wants to throw it on second down. And he's going to go down. The Texans come out.
Tua Tagovailoa
to bring him to the ground.
by Jadeveon
Clowney.
A loss
and
of 10
that'll be
yards
down
on the play.
First sack of the
it's
game.
Now
well, they had six
down.
Last week. And this offense did its homework, didn't it? Because they saw all that pressure, and they really worked hard to tamp it down and beat it back. And they did a great job in the first half. But now they've gotten the first sack here in the second half. Look out, they're trying to increase the
pressure.
And take this to the other side of the field before going off balance. The defense shaking their heads, not aggressive enough, and they allow them to convert on 3rd and 18. Setting to throw on first down is Tua. Got the connection here to Bourne. And able to break one tackle. And they're a nice little gain.
10-4 yards.
A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
10 yards on the pickup.
So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard. On play action. Here's Tua. Steps away. And the pressure gets there, and Tua is going to be taken down.
Well, they had the right down and the definite distance to take
an
a shot downfield.
But
it didn't work out the way that they envisioned.
So that's a situation where if you take a sack close to the line of scrimmage, it's not that bad. But a loss like that, you can't take a sack there.
Yeah, absolutely. The one thing you cannot do, they did.
Out of the gun on third down, here's Tua. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked off here by Jimmy Smith. And now off to the races down the right side. And they will
touchdown,
score
Houston.
Pick six for the
Steven
Texans team.
For the extra point.
This game's still fairly well at hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell and just run the football?
I think you have to, but you also have to tell your backs, make sure you're really protecting the football because you're going to run into a stacked defensive front, which is why they were throwing the football before, trying to make sure they just get their backs, you know, really beat up in that situation. Now, good luck to them.
The Steelers take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And the pick six we just saw makes things a little more interesting. Still, though, a two-possession game as they control their destiny in this fourth quarter. Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. He was
Nola
looking for his tight end, Devin Asiasi, there.
For Devin Asiasi. Incomplete. It's now 2nd and 10.
Here's Tagovailoa to throw. Screen pass to Connor. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31.
Complete to James Conner.
Steelers on 3rd down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point.
Four.
This is 3rd and 4. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. Open man completes it to Smith-Schuster. And he will have his Steelers first down as they're able to jump the 3rd down conversion.
Fourth and 10. Now offense is not nearly as precise as days gone by. They just saw receivers find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you. And that's exactly what they did on that play. First with the pass through the air. Nice chunk of yardage there. And then additional pickup with his legs after the catch.
Yard line. A gain of 2 brings up 2nd and 8.
Again, it's Connor. And he works it past the 30, close to the 25.
That's good.
11 yards there, the first down. I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What do they have to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
1st and goal.
Good pickup there, 21 yards. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Rush coming, and he's taken down.
Tagovailoa.
It's Darius Leonard, the linebacker who got in and got into the turf. They try again on 2nd and goal after going backwards to the 12. Two are going to throw. And the ball is out. And the Texans scoop it. And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. He's at the 40. 30. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line. A little careless with the football. He also fumbled us last week, didn't he?
He certainly did. And when I'm watching him play, the one thing that comes to mind is always remember. Turbulence, people around you. Two hands.
Complete
two hands on the ball. Keep it tight. I know it looks
good. It's a game of five. Brings up second and five.
Tuck it away because you've got to take care of it.
At the 17-yard line.
Throwing again on second down. Mayfield. And that is caught. Touchdown, Texans! Complete to Gronkowski, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Texans use the short field to their advantage
as they cash in for the two-point conversion.
All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. They're going to run it with Barkley. And he'll get into the end zone as the two-point conversion is successful.
Texans 21. Mitch Wishnowski set to kick.
Here's Wishnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. Fielded in the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been. And he's going down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
The
Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And that ball popped free. We could hear it all the way up here. Those guys down on the field alerting everyone to a fumble. He's lucky that his offensive mates picked him up and jumped on him.
Yeah, and you have to think to yourself, and I'm sure they've been echoing it on the sideline and into the huddle. Guys, we have the lead. Just take care of the football. Don't make it easier for them to start to make a comeback.
So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset.
So they keep the ball, but work to do on second and long.
From the gun, it's Tua. Open man is born. And they'll get it all the way up the goal line. And shot at midfield. A game winner of 30 big ones. So that changes things. Here's first and 10 yard line at the 45. Escaping the pressure right. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down.
And set.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
So following the sack, they'll try to change their fortune here on second and 13. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And the Texans are running the first of their timeouts.
Taken down.
As I'm talking over here before what will be an important game again.
Makes it third and 11.
Back to throw is Tua. Oh, wide open, complete. And he'll be down deep in the Houston territory.
James.
Now the Texans will use one of their two remaining timeouts.
Steelers.
As again, with just a shade under a minute to go in the game. The Steelers were last in the NFL in red zone touchdown percentage a season ago, down around 35%. It's first and goal. They'll run here with Connor. And this is going to result in losing yardage.
On the
They're driven back to the 8-yard line.
Deshaun Gibson brought him down.
The Texans going to signal for the third and final timeout.
Second and goal.
As they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. Again, it'll be Connor. And he maneuvers his way down to the 3-yard line.
Again, the ball carrier.
It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to set up a third and goal.
A gain of 5 yards brings up third and goal.
To throw is Tua. And this is caught. And knocked on ceiling. It's a touchdown.
Touchdown.
They have to love seeing that from our young quarterback here in the fourth quarter. Able to further that lead with a touchdown pass.
He didn't go total, did he? And you know what I mean by that? Those coaches say all the time, hey, when we have a lead late, don't just tuck in and try to ride it out. Go out and play and extend the lead. That's what he did.
Good with the extra point. These guys will take a 10-point lead.
Sanchez now. He'll kick it away following the touchdown. DeAndre Carter returning it. Breaks a tackle. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
The Texans take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of them.
That's caught inside the 20. He takes it across for the touchdown. They've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow.
Steven Gostkowski.
No, we're not cheering. No, we're not rooting. But I am excited about this. I know you are, too. We got a ball game again after that big time strike.
Big time strike, and you are right. Don't go anywhere yet. This thing's not done. Extra point, goodbye, Gostkowski. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter.
Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown.
Steelers take over the back first end zone,
so we will start here at the 25. They go down to a knee and a sigh of relief as they are into the win column for the first time this year. On the run is Connor. And he'll take this for a short gain on what will prove to be the final play of this ball game.
31, Texans 28.
We saw a comeback bid fall just a little short, but give them credit. They were able to hold on, withstand that comeback, and ultimately win it by the slim margin.
And bottom line, when it's all said and done, they don't ask you how much you won by. They just want to know, did you win? And that they did.
So for Pittsburgh, they're into the win column now as they move to 1-2 on the young season. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Tennessee Titans. Meanwhile, for Houston, they suffer defeat for the first time as they drop to 2-1. And they'll get a home date next week against the Minnesota Vikings. So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. The Steelers are winners as we say so long from Heinz Field.
All of them fake, I see both faces. Scared of the whip, it's a ghost racing. I'm not gonna